Today we will do methods of charging a body. Three methods we will consider. One is rubbing, second is conduction, and third is induction. Rubbing we have done already, that when we are going to work against friction, then both the bodies are going to get charged due to transfer of electron. One is gaining, other is losing. The object that is gaining will get negative charge, and the object that is losing will get positively charged. So we will not go for rubbing in much detail. We will go for conduction. Conduction means when there is an actual contact between the body that is to be charged and the body that is producing the charge or that is already charged. So in this case, in conduction, actual contact should be there between both the bodies. This is the charge rod already we are going to have. So this is charged, negatively charged. So this has excess of electron with itself. And between these electrons, there will be repulsion. And if we are going to keep it in front of a metallic box, this is uncharged. Air is insulator in between them, so it will not allow these charged particles to flow from this side to this side. But when we will bring in contact, then what will happen? Electron will move from this side to this side. There will be loss of electron in this charge rod, and this metallic box will get charged. It's not like that all the electrons will get transferred to it. Because when it few electrons will transfer here, then they will not welcome the other electrons to come. So there will be a limit to which this body can be charged. And here loss of charge will be there by charged body. So contact is necessary. Similar charge will be transferring and loss of charge will be there associated with charge rod. Third, what we are going to do is induction. In case of induction, contact will not be there. Gap will be there. So if we will consider the case of metals at room temperature, then electrons, loosely bound electrons, are going to become free. So atom we can consider in the form of ion and electron. So this is picture of metal with us. Electron separated, ion, like this we are going to have in case of metal crystal lattice. Now this is rod that is having charge on itself, means these are inducing charges, and this is metallic piece or metallic object that we have. In this we have positive negative means initially charge present on this is neutral, and this we have kept on insulating stand, and we want to give charge on this body, and we are going to have negatively charged rod with us. Now what is to be done? One end of this metallic box we are going to connect with earth. So when we are connecting with earth, this side the electrons which are present, they will flow here. And excess of charge that is left with us will be these three positive. All electrons cannot flow because they are bound with attractive forces with these ions also. So few electrons will flow, and as a result, excess of positive charge will remain here. So this is third step where negatively charged rod is kept close to this metallic object. Contact is not there, gap is there, and we have connected its one end to earth. And in this step, see, electrons have gone to earth, and we are going to have excess of positive charge here. No loss of charge is there in this rod. After this, what we have to do, we will remove this connection from earth, and after this we will remove this rod that was inducing charge on this. Then these charges, they are giving net charge to be zero, and this charge will get uniformly distributed on the metallic object. So this object we have made positively charged. In this case, contact is not there, and this is not losing the charge also. So few questions I will be giving you in assignment that you have to do, which are based on the conduction, induction and rubbing. Next part that I am going to consider is Coulomb's law. Before stating Coulomb's law, point charge should be clear to us. What is point charge? When the size of the charge body is very small as compared to distance between them, then we can consider those charge bodies to be point charge. And when we are stating Coulomb's law, then two things we have to keep in our mind, that in case of charges, if they will be similarly charged, there will be force of attraction. If oppositely charged, there will be force of repulsion. So according to Coulomb's law, for charges which are stationary and point charges, the force of attraction or repulsion will be directly proportional to product of charges and inversely proportional to square of distance between them, and it will act along the line joining the two charges. And when we will remove this proportionality sign, constant of proportionality will be there, K. So F is equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R square, where K is electrostatic force constant and its value is 9 into 10 raised to power 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. So you have to solve few numericals which are based on Coulomb's law. That's all.